Hello everyone, this is going to be a video on how to replace an alternator on a Ecotec 2.4 liter engine that's right next to the airbox under there. It's kind of hard to see, but the pulley is right there. This is the first one on top, and this is because it's been given. By the way, this is a 2011 Chevy Equinox, and this applies to 2010 to 2016 Chevy Equinox with a 2.4 liter Ecotec engine. It's been giving different types of errors while driving, that the power saving mode stability track needs attention and the power steering needs to be checked, and that's because the body is not being charged by the alternator. The battery runs out of juice, out of power, and that's therefore the computer does all those crazy things, tries to save power, and then the whole lights and all the lights on the board turn off due to the fact that it's trying to save more power for the car to work. Okay, so this is going to be about replacing the alternator. It's going to be from the top, and this is how you do it. You first of all remove the engine shroud and the airbox. These two things are being removed first. The first one, the engine cover from that flathead screwdriver, you loosen it on top of the throttle body. And then this one here to remove the engine shroud here, and then disconnect this hose, and then as soon as I'm done I'll come back for more. Then after the airbox or the engine shroud is removed, then you take off the two bolts behind the airbox here. They are 10 millimeter bolts. Take them off and then wiggle the airbox and unplug this plug with pressing, pulling it, getting it away, and then kind of pull the airbox out of the way. So there's more space to take the alternator, which is right here, and then you can take the dust cover here too, so you have more space taking out the oil refill cap. So let's continue to remove. Then after that is removed, then we're gonna remove this piece here, which is attached with two 14 millimeter bolts here. I have already pre-loosened. See how it's moving? So I'm gonna take that off, these two bolts here, and then I'm gonna have a clear view of the alternator. I'm gonna try to keep everything plugged. Hopefully only I'm gonna detach this plug here, but basically this is coming off. Okay, let me take it off. 14 millimeter bolts. Okay, once I get that removed, I just remove the plug that was on top. This one I kind of use, twist it around and put it on top of the throttle body. It's a good idea to cover that with a rag so nothing gets inside of the throttle body, not dirt or anything. I'm going to do that right now. And I'm sorry, I apologize, but there were 13 millimeter sockets for the removal of these two, and this is for the alternator. There's two on the top, this one and this one, and there might be two on the bottom, because I see one around here, maybe another one underneath.
So I'm going to do that right now. But first, we have to loosen the serpentine belt, and that's with a long breaker bar, I believe, or if not, also a 13 millimeter or 17, I think is that one right here, to loosen it. You can save the configuration and take a picture of it so you can put it back, or just you can just look it online. Up the alternator under this pulley here, that's a tension belt, under the grabs the compressor, and then the flywheel goes over, and that's it. There's no other belt or tensioner behind here, so it only goes like that under the tensioner and then back. So I'm gonna see, I think it's the how can I loosen it, and I'll tell you right now.
Okay, and after to remove the serpentine belt, you have to put in a regular 3/8 of an inch ratcheting wrench, and kind of put it in between. There's a square. It's kind of hard to see, and then my wrench, this is a cobalt, it's kind of thick, chunky, and kind of fit it in like most Chevys, and then pull it up and you'll see how the tension is relieved. I'm not gonna try to leave my camera here. Pull it up and then you see the tension relieved. I'm gonna just jump it out from the, watch out for the fingers, out of the alternator, which is the one, and it's kind of hard with one finger. Okay, now I let it go. Watch out with the fingers, and then remove the wrench out of the hole, the square hole, and that's how you take out the serpentine belt. I'm just gonna leave it right there. I'm sorry you don't see, because dealing with a camera. I'm just gonna leave it right there, and that's already loose. I'm sorry. And I just confirmed these two bolts under two, the 13 millimeter one here, and two right under, right next to each other under the alternator, and they have to come off in order for this baby to come and be replaced. Okay, I just took off the two bolts on the top, the four 13 millimeter bolts, and I just confirmed there's only one under, there's not two, there's only three holding the alternator, and I'm running out of battery, I'm sorry. It's a good practice to take, disconnect the battery just in case, because you're gonna disconnect into the positive going for through the alternator, so you don't want to short circuit any cables. Okay, so that is out of the way, battery is disconnected. I'm gonna try to wiggle around the alternator, and it's mostly loose. Okay, now I kind of leave it hanging around, watch out for it not to go, and just unplug any plugs, like this small plug, this may be just a like a voltage plug, and then holding it, hoping for it not to fall or damage anything. Then I have to remove, there's another bolt here, my guess is a, let me just put the camera, it's also a 13 millimeter. This is positive, by the way. If you haven't disconnected the battery, do this now. You could put a wrench or just like a anything that helps. I put my, if I can get in the way, I'm sorry, but I'll try to loosen it first. Oh, there you go. It's loose. I'm just gonna do it by hand. Okay. Try to loose the, this is a positive connection. Again, disconnect the battery. This is the one supplying the, there you go. I saved my bolts and nuts. And now I just pull out the alternator. Look how simple it was. Took me less than 20 minutes of, and 10 minutes of video. I made the video because I didn't see any video on YouTube trying to replace the alternator on 2010-2016 Equinoxes. So please give it a thumbs up, like it, so, because I'm the first one that I've seen that removes out of the Equinoxes or two terrains since they have the same engine. Okay, that's the part number if you need it. They're pretty inexpensive. And I'm just gonna double confirm that it's not good by spinning it or maybe putting my, what is called, my drill, impact drill here, and spinning it just to confirm it's not giving any voltage out. That's going to be the positive here. This is the negative, so I'm just gonna double make sure. Might do another video, but that was it. This is a bath alternator. That's why the Equinox keeps turning off and getting a bunch of errors saying that the power has been saved, or the stability track needs to be addressed, or even the power steering or shutting off, and then it takes like less than 5 minutes for it to completely go out. Again, please give it a thumbs up. You can get this part used for about 40 bucks on eBay. So, thank you very much.